Hello friends, in today's lecture we will learn how to find term symbols for a multi-electron system with the help of LS or also called Russell-Saunders coupling scheme. But before discussing this, we must have a look back at quantum numbers which are used to describe atomic orbitals. So the first quantum number called principal quantum number denoted by small n, it can have any positive integer value starting from 1, it can go up to infinity. So value of n tells us about the shell in which the electron is present. So positive integer means the value of n will be a whole number, it cannot be fraction. So n can have any value starting from 1 up to infinity, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. The next quantum number called orbital quantum number, which is denoted by symbol small l, and the value of l depends upon the value of n. For a given value of n, l can have values starting from 0, adding 1 and going up to n minus 1. Example, suppose n is 4. So n minus 1 is 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So what value of l can be? We will start from 0 and go on adding 1, 0. 1, 2, 3. So L can have 4 values. It can be either 0, 1, 2 or 3 when n is equal to 4. So the value of L tells us about the orbital in which the electron is present. For a given value of L, we have given a specific symbol for orbitals. Like if L is 0, we denote that orbital with small s. An orbital for which L is equal to 1 is denoted by small p. If L is 2, we denote it by small d, and so on. The value of L determines the shape of an atomic orbital, as I mentioned, and the orbital angular momentum of the electron. The next quantum number is called magnetic quantum number. It is given by symbol ML. It gives information about the directionality of atomic orbital or orientation of atomic orbital, and the value of ML depends upon value of L. For a given L, ML can have value starting from minus L, we will keep adding 1, 0 up to plus 1. Now let us understand this. Suppose L is 3. So ML can be, we will start from minus 3, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, then 1, 2, and 3. It can have 7 values. When L is equal to 1, ML can have values minus 1, 0, plus 1. It can have 3 values. So now L is 1, it denotes p orbitals. It has 3 orientation, minus 1 with values of ML equal to minus 1, 0 and plus 1. So we have 3 p orbitals. Similarly, we have 5 d orbitals. The next quantum number is spin quantum number, which is noted by symbol small s. It determines the spin angular momentum of an electron. It has a value of half. Next quantum number is magnetic spin quantum number denoted by small ms, it can have two values for electron. Either it can be minus half or it can be plus half. This corresponds to anticlockwise spin, and this corresponds to clockwise spin of electron around its axis. So in order to define an electron in an atomic orbital, we need four quantum numbers, n, l, ml and ms. And we also know that we can have only two values of ms, so this limits that an orbital can have maximum of only two electrons. Now we will come to our main topic, term symbols. Now we know that an electron has spin angular momentum s. This comes from the rotation of electron around its own axis, like Earth is rotating around its axis. Electron is also rotating about its axis. And we also know that electron is revolving around the nucleus. So it generates orbital angular momentum, which is calculated from quantum number L. Now, for multi-electron atom, means atom having more than one electron in a orbitals, these individual spin angular momentum and orbital angular momentum, they will interact or couple with one another to give you resultant angular momentum. So these S and L values, they will couple with each other to give resultant angular momentum. Now, so to indicate these interactions and the electronic configuration and the resultant angular momentum, it comes from the interaction of S and L. We use term symbols which are of the form of this. This is term symbol, where capital S is total spin angular quantum number, capital L is total orbital angular quantum number, capital J is total angular momentum quantum number, and 2s plus 1 is called spin multiplicity of the state. So in order to find a term symbol, we must know value of S, value of capital L and value of capital L. So that is our main topic of interest today, how to calculate these values of capital S, capital L and capital J. And to calculate these values, we just should know addition. By addition, we will get these values. Now, like for small values of small l, we have atomic symbol for orbital. So similarly, for values of capital L, we have the value of capital L, we have different symbols. Like if L is 0, it is denoted by small s and it is called energy state. So the value of capital L corresponds to a specific energy state. If L is 0, the energy state is capital S. If L is 2, the energy state is capital D. If L is 1, the energy state is denoted by capital P, and so on. You can look at the table. So in the term symbol, instead of the value of L, we will use the symbol which will correspond to that value. Now suppose, let us take an imaginary case, like suppose if S is 0, L is 1, and J is also 1. So for these three values, the term symbol will be, now look at this, put the value of 0. 2 multiplied by 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. So we get 1. Now L is 1, so for 1 we will use the symbol capital P, it is P, and J is 1. So this is a, this complete thing is called term symbol. So that is how we will define term symbol. So now how to find the value of capital L and capital S. So in order to find the value of capital L, capital S and capital J, we will take the help of LS coupling, also called Russell-Saunders coupling scheme. This scheme is applicable to systems in which spin orbital interactions are small. We also have some other coupling scheme called JJ coupling scheme, but that we will not discuss. We will discuss only Russell-Saunders coupling scheme. So in this scheme, first thing is to calculate the value of capital L. L is resultant orbital angular momentum, and its value is calculated by coupling of individual orbital angular momentum from values of small l. We will see in the next coming slides how to calculate capital L. Just now remember that to find the term symbol using LS scheme, first thing is to calculate the value of capital N, and it is calculated from value of small l. Next thing is we will calculate value of capital S, which is called resultant spin momentum. Similarly, it is calculated from coupling of individual electron spin momenta, that is from small s. We will discuss in coming slides how to find value of S. So the next task is to calculate value of J, which is calculated from value of capital L and value of capital S. So in order to find term symbol using this LS coupling scheme, the first task is to calculate value of capital L, which is calculated from small l. Next step is to calculate the value of capital S, which is calculated from small s. And the next step is to calculate J, which is determined from coupling of capital S with capital L with capital S. So the value of J can have any value, but it is always positive. J cannot have a negative value. So J can have values starting from L minus S. This sign corresponds to modulus, means this number will always be a positive number. So the value of J will start from L minus L, and they will go up to L plus S by difference of 1. Let us try to understand this. Suppose L is 1, S is also 1. Now L plus S is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, and L minus S is 1 minus 1 is 0. So now see what he says. J can have values from L minus L to L plus L by difference of 1. L minus S is 0, so we have to go from 0 up to 2 by difference of 1. So J can have three values: 0, 1 or 2. So that's what I have written here. So the value of J, what we will write first, we will write the value of L plus L, or anything you can write value of L minus L. Then we will start subtracting 1 from it, and we will go up to when we will get L minus S. So these will give the value of J. We will apply this formula in the coming slides. So now let us see how to find capital S. This is found using SS coupling. So we know that spin quantum number of electron is S is equal to 1/2. Now for two or more electrons, but now suppose electron is revolving around its axis. So whenever a charge moves, it always produces a magnetic field. So now we say, suppose we have two electrons, both of these two electrons have S is equal to 1/2. Now both are revolving around their axis, so both are producing magnetic field. So their magnetic field will couple to produce a resultant spin quantum number denoted by capital S. So likewise, J, S can have only positive values. S only can be greater than or equal to zero. It can be equal to zero, but it can never be less than zero, and its value will come from S minus S1 minus S2 to S1 plus S2. Let us try to understand. S is equal to, similarly we can write, we will start from S1 plus S2 and will go up to S1 minus S2 by difference of 1. Let us try to understand it for a P2 system. Means two electrons in a P orbital or D2 systems. Two electrons in a D2 system. Now for both of the electrons, let us, I have denoted one electron by 1 and second electron by 2. Both of the electrons, S is half. So we can write S1 is also half, S2 is also half. So S1 plus S2 comes out to be half plus half is equal to 1. S1 minus S2 comes out to be equal to half minus half 0. Now let us apply this formula. So capital S will be, we will start from S1 plus S2. S1 plus S2 is 1. We will go up to S1 minus S2 by difference of 0. Now 1 minus 1 is 0. So we have got S1 minus S2. So we can have only two values of S. It can be either 1 or 0. So S can be either 1 or 0. Now like 2S plus 1 is called spin multiplicity, and we have a table here where I have shown that if 2s plus 1 comes out to be equal to 1, then we will name it as a singlet state. If it comes out to be 2, we will name it as a doublet state. If it comes out to be 3, we will name it as triplet state, and so on. So that is how we calculate capital S from values of small s. Please remember these values because we will use these values in the coming slides. Now let us see how to calculate capital L. This is calculated by L-L coupling scheme, similar to S-S coupling scheme. Now let us consider two electrons with angular quantum numbers L1 and L2. It is L. Or we can say L1 and L1 both can have same value, or both can also have different value. Suppose we have two electrons, one with angular quantum number L1 and another is angular quantum number L2. Now similar to S, L also can have only positive values. It can be equal to zero, but it can never be less than zero. It will be either zero or greater than zero. So for two electrons L1 and L2, L can have values starting from L1 minus L2, we will keep on adding 1, and up to L1 plus L2, or we can represent it reversely, like L can be L1 plus L2, we have to go up to L1 minus L2 by a difference of 1. Now value of L gives energy states. Like I mentioned in my previous slide, if L is 0, we denote it by capital S. If L is 1, we denote that state by capital P. Now again, I am showing this table for you. Now let us try to calculate value of capital L for a P2 system. Now P2 system means two electrons are in the P orbital. So for P orbital, value of small l is 1 for P orbital. So we all know that for P orbital l is 1. So as both of the electrons are present in same orbital, so L1 is also 1 and L2 is also 1. So to calculate capital L, first we will find L1 plus L2 and L1 minus L2. Now L1 plus L2 is, L1 plus L2 is 1 plus 1, 2. L1 minus L2 is 1 minus 1, 0. Now what we have to do, the value of L, we will start from L1 plus L2 and we will go up to L1 minus L2 by a difference of 1. So let us start from 2. So 2, 2 minus 1 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So we can have these three values of capital L for P2 system. L can be 0, 1, 2. Please remember it. We will use in the coming slides. Similarly, we can say P2 system is represented by three energy states. For L is equal to 0, energy state is S. For L is equal to 1, energy state is P. And for L is equal to 2, energy state is called capital D. Now let us try to find for D2 system, as both the electrons are present in D orbital, and for D orbital small l is 2. So L1 is also 2, L2 is also 2. So L1 plus L2 comes out to be 4. L1 minus L2 comes out to be 0. So to find capital L, what we will do? We will start from 4. We will keep subtracting 1, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we will go up to L1 minus L2, which is 0. So we can have these five values of capital L for a D2 system: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can define these by energy states S, P, D, F, and D. Now let us try to find the term symbol for SP system. Suppose we have S1, P1 system. Now for this system, as one electron is in S orbital, so L1 is 0. For this system, L2 is equal to 1 because it is present in P orbital. So L1 plus L2 is 1 plus 0, 1. L1 minus L2 is 1 minus 0, 1. So both values are same. So we can have only one value, L equal to 1. Now for, let us see, P1 D1 system. P1 D1. So L1 is equal to 1 as it is present in P orbital, and L2 is equal to 2. So L1 plus L2 is 1 plus 2, 3. L1 minus L2 is 1 minus 2, minus 1, but we have to use modulus, so we will take it as 1. So L1 plus L2 is 3, L1 minus L2 is 1. So the term symbol will be, we will start from L1 plus L2, 3. We will keep subtracting 1, 3, 2, and 1. We will go up to L1 minus L2. So these three values of capital L are possible for P1 D1 system. Now, so far we have calculated, we have seen how to calculate capital S and capital L. Now, let us see how to calculate capital J. So, J is calculated from spin orbital or called LS coupling. So, what happens? Magnetic fields of resultant angular momentum L and resultant spin momentum S, they couple to give quantum number J, which is called total angular quantum number. Now J is determined from capital L and capital S. J can have only positive values starting from L minus S, and it will go up to L plus S. So we can write this formula is important. J is equal to modulus L plus S. Then we will go up to L minus S modulus by difference of 1. So now let us try to find the value of J for P2 system. So in our previous slide, we know that for P2 system, S is 0 and 1 and L is 0, 1, 2. So we can have 6 states for such an arrangement. 6 states, let us see how it become. First is suppose S is 0 and we will use this to find the energy state or called term symbol. So far we don't know the value of J. Let us try to put the value of X and L in this expression. We will not use J. Now first case is S is 0, L is 0. S 0, L 0. Now put the value of S and L here. S 0 means 1, L 0 means S. So the state is 1S. If S is 0, L is 1. Now S is 0, it will remain 1. And L 1, that means it is 1P. If S is 1 and L is, sorry, S is 0 and L is 2, the state will become 1D. Similarly, for S 1 and L 0, it is 3S. For S 1, L 1, it is 3P. And for S 1 and L 2, it is 3D. But in order to find a complete term symbol, we should also know J. So I have formulated a table in which I have drawn the different permutations between these two, like S can be 0, L can be 0. Either we can have S 0, L 1. We can have S 0, L 2. We can have S 1, L 0, S 1, L 1, S 1 and L 2. Now we will try to find the value of J for these systems. Now to find the value of J, what we should know? We should know L plus S as well as L minus S. Now put L, suppose let us calculate it for this case. S 0, L 0. So L plus S is 0. L minus S is also 0. So we can have only one value, 0. So for this, the term symbol will become, now put this value here. S 0. So 2 multiplied by 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. We get 1. L is also 0. So for L0, the symbol is capital S. So J is 0. So we have put here 0. So this is the complete term symbol for this arrangement. Now let us find for this arrangement. When S is 0, L is 1. Now L plus S is 0 plus 1, 1. L minus S is 1 minus 0, again 1. So we can have only L plus S is also 1, L minus S is also 1. So capital J is, we will start from L plus S and go up to L minus S, as both are same value. So we can have only one value, P. So the term symbol becomes this 0, it becomes 1. L 1, the symbol is capital P, and here comes 1. This is the term symbol for S0, L1 and J1 value. Now let us try to find for S0, L2 and J2. Now L plus S is 2, L minus S is 2 minus 0, 2. So again we can have only one value of J2. The symbol will become 1D2. Now here a very important thing is coming, that if either one of these two is 0, we will get only one value of J. Please remember, if either of these two is 0, we will get only one value of J. Why? Because in that case, L plus S and L minus S will be same. Now let us try to calculate for this. S1, L, 0. So L plus S, 0 plus 1 is 1. L minus S, 0 minus 1 is minus 1, but we have to use the modulus. It is also 1. So it has only one value, 1. Now the symbol becomes, now S is 1. Put here, 2 multiplied by 1 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. So we get 3. Now L. L is 0. For this symbol is capital S and J is 1. So So this is the term symbol for S1 L0 J1. Now let us calculate the term symbol for S1 and L1. I will erase all this so that we can understand. Okay, now let us try to do for S1 and L1. First calculate L plus S. L plus S is 1 plus 1 is 2. L minus S. 1 minus 1 is 0. Now calculate J. Now J value, they will start from L plus S. This L plus S. 2. And they will go up to L minus S. L minus S is 0. By difference of 1. Now 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So we have started from L plus S and we have gone up to L minus S by difference of 1. So we can have 3 values of J. J can be either 2, either 1 or 0. So I have represented here when S is 1, L is 1, J can have 3 values. J can be 2, J can be 1, J can be 0. So we can have 3 term symbols. When S is 1, L is 1 and J is 2, the term symbol becomes S is 1 means 2S plus 1 is 3. L is 1, that means it is capital P. So J is 2 means 3P2. Similarly for 1, 1, 1, it becomes 3P1. For 1, 1, 0, it becomes 3P0. Now, let us see the final case when S is 1, L is 2. Same, try to find L plus S. L plus S is 1 plus 2, 3. L minus S is 2 minus 1 is 1. So value of J will start from L plus S. L plus S is 3. We will go up to L minus S. L minus S is 1 by difference of 1. So 3, 2 and 1. For this system, when S is 1, L is 2, we can have 3 values of J, 3, 2 and 1. Again, we can have 3 term symbols, 3D3, 3D2 and 3D1. Now, why D? Because L is 2. If L is 2, the state symbol is D. So, this is how we calculated the term symbols for P2 configuration. We get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 term symbols. But this P2 configuration, it can be of two types. Means it can be NP1 and N-P1. Like these two, it may be 2P and 3P. 2P1, 3P1 is P2 configuration. For such a system, all these term symbols will be valid. But if we have this system, the two electrons are in the same shell, like 2p2. In that case, some of these term symbols, they will become invalid. So in such this system is called excited state. This system is called ground state. So ground state term symbols, we find from electronic configuration that I will discuss in my next lecture. So similarly, now we will find term symbol for D2 configuration. For D2 configuration, we know that S is 0, 1 and L can have values 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 as discussed earlier. So similarly, now we will try to see how many states without J values. When S is 0, L is 0, which state? 1S. S0, L1, which state? 1P. S0, L2, it is 1D. S0, L3, it is 1F. And S0, L4, it is 1G. Now, S1, L0, it is 3S. S1, L1, it is 3P. S1, L2, it is 3D. S1, L3, it is 3F and S1, L4, it is 3P. जी, सो वी कैन हैव 10 सिंबल्स विदाउट कंसिडरिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ जे. नाउ लेट अस कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ जे. इफ वी कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ जे फॉर ऑल दीज परमुटेशन, सो आई हैव मेड ऑल दीज परमुटेशन. हाउ मैनी परमुटेशन? एस जीरो एल जीरो, एस जीरो एल वन, एस जीरो एल टू. सो वी गेट 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 केसेज. एंड वेन वी फाइंड the term symbol for all these cases, it comes out to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 term symbols. If we also consider value of j, you can similarly apply likewise we applied earlier. I will choose any one of these two to explain. Suppose I have chosen this S0L1. So S0L1 means L plus S is 2. L minus S is 0. So J means we will start from L plus S 2 and we will go up to L minus S 0 by difference of 1. 2, 1, 0. So we can have 3 term symbols. S is 1, so 2S plus 1 is 3. L is 1, so it is capital P. J is 2, it is 3P. 2. For this system 111, it is 3P1. 4110, it is 3P0. Now let us try to calculate for this system when S is 1, L is 4. So L plus S is 4 plus 1, 5. L minus S, 4 minus 1, 3. So J value means we will start from L plus S, 5. We will go up to L minus S, 3 by difference of 1. 5 minus 1 is 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. So we will get only 3 values, 5, 4, 3. So the symbols become 3D5, 3D4 and 3D3. Similarly, you can find term symbol for any system. I hope you have understand the topic. Please try to do it by yourself so that you can learn properly. So far in this lecture, we studied some basic thing, how to find the term symbol for a given configuration from value of L and S. In my next lecture, I will show you how to find the term symbols from electronic configuration of atoms and how to find the ground state terms. If you like the video, please do subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.